Hello everyone, my name is Sana Chhabra and I have secured All India Rank 84 in UPSC Civil Services Examination of 2018. And today I'll be discussing with you the society part of GS Paper 1, which deals specifically with certain topics that I would mention. Before discussing how to go about this paper, I would first read out the syllabus so that we get to know what to prepare and what not to prepare. Beginning with the topic written in the syllabus, it says salient features of Indian society and diversity of India, role of women in women's organizations, population and associated issues, poverty and development issues, urbanization, their problems and their remedies. Then there are two more topics, effects of globalization on Indian society, and last is social empowerment, communalism, regionalism and secularism. So if we see the paper and the previous year papers in the syllabus of this part, I believe that this paper requires no specific knowledge. I mean that it is a very generic part of GS Paper 1 where you can attempt answers in a beautiful manner if you have been reading the newspaper consistently. So if we see the previous year question paper, say of 2018, we would see that the questions directly come from the keywords written in the syllabus. For instance, one of the questions was, despite implementation of various programs for eradication of poverty by Government of India, poverty is still existing, explained by giving reasons. And this question is directly picked up from the topic poverty and development issues, which shows that if we go through the society part topic by topic, word by word, which is given in the syllabus, we'll be able to manage this part, which gives at least 3 to 4 or maybe 5 questions every year. So as far as my strategy was concerned, I had sociology as my optional subject, so there was no specific requirement of going through this part of the syllabus as I was already prepared. But for those of you who do not have sociology as your optional subject, I would say that you can go through the NCERT for sociology of class 11th and 12th, which deals with all these broad topics very beautifully. And with that, you'll develop a good base regarding Indian society. And if there are some topics that you're unable to find in that NCERT, I recommend that you Google those topics and read an essay or two on those topics specifically dealing with Indian society. Other than that, there are always 1 to 2 newspapers in a week which deal with the Indian society part as far as the editorials are concerned. So if you're consistent with newspaper reading, I believe that Indian society part which deals with the current aspect would be covered automatically. And the newspaper can be either the Hindu or the Indian Express or both, whatever is convenient to you. Other than that, another government source which deals with Indian society is Yojana. So there are certain issues of Yojana that specifically deal with social issues, be it social sector schemes or social empowerment, or sometimes dealing directly with topics like globalization or women empowerment. For instance, there was this topic in the question paper last year, women's movement in India has not addressed the issues of women of lower social strata. So one of the Yojanas that covered the issues of women last year. So I believe that it is very important to go through the newspaper and Yojana to cover this part of the syllabus. Other than that, we all read government schemes and that should be kept handy. And while attempting the answers, the focus should be on the structuration. By structuration, I mean we should understand the demand of the question. If we do that, we will be able to answer the society part in a sociological manner. So, for instance, there was this question on women in India and the various schemes which are not dealing with women of lower strata. So you can very well begin with the introduction of, the condition of women of lower strata in India. And then you can proceed by talking of various government schemes which have been implemented, focusing on women of social strata, of lower social strata, and then probably you can discuss the loopholes that the scheme has or certain areas which the scheme is not dealing with, and then give an optimistic conclusion regarding what the improvement can be or what other scheme or certain improvement that you suggest. That would be the ideal structuration of the answer. So that is all about society part of GS1. wherein I will summarize what I said, that read newspaper very carefully and specifically the issues that deal with Indian society. Yojana should be done very carefully. Next, if you want a good base for sociology or the society part, then plus one, plus two NCRTs are good. Other than that, you should practice a lot of answer writing so that you develop the key of structuration. Thank you.
Don't forget to subscribe with us and press the bell icon to never miss the video on Chanakya IAS Academy.